But first, skateboarding has been considered a sport, art form, and even a lifestyle by people devoted to the activity. Here in Chicago, a new skateboard program is helping young people break out of the pandemic blues by learning the basics while picking up valuable life lessons along the way. Chicago Tonight's Evan Garcia recently skated over to the South Side to learn more.
Go, 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 go.
The second week of a youth skateboard program in Chicago starts slow, with participants seated on boards during a race. But by the end of the session, the young skaters are already learning new tricks.
It's really fun, and I think I'm getting better, and I'm learning to do ollies now. Say if there's another skateboard on the ground, and an ollie is when you jump over it while you're riding, and then you land.
The lessons are a collaboration between the Boys and Girls Club of Chicago and the Chill Foundation, a nonprofit started in 1995 by Burton Snowboards, which runs programs across the world.
Our overall mission is to teach kids how to overcome challenges through board sports. We understand that in Chicago there may be a lot of challenges, different economic situations or socioeconomic things that may be challenging. But here at Chill, our goal is to help them push through that. And if they can see that they can do that on the board, then why can't they do that in regular life?
This year's spring session is taking place in Bridgeport at the Lewis L. Valentine's Boys and Girls Club. The club's art instructor, Tamaris Dennis, is learning alongside the young people while assisting them.
They do look to adults for inspiration. And just seeing me be brave enough to attempt getting on the board is, I wouldn't say the first thing that got them on the board, but it'll definitely get them getting back on the board. Like, oh, if Tamaris is trying it, then I'll try it too. Like, there's nothing to be afraid of.
The skateboard program started here in East Garfield Park at the Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Boys and Girls Club. Classes began in the fall during a surge in COVID-19 cases.
It was just a breath of fresh air. COVID-19 really had an effect on youth's physical, mental, social health. And so Chill really had, you know, just gave the opportunity for you to, you know, be outside, social distance, but also learn a skill and socialize with their peers.
2 years ago, I spoke with instructor Christopher Long for a story on a Chicago Park District skateboard program. Through the Chill Foundation, he's continuing to teach the lessons he learned as a young skater.
Learning a lot about myself through skateboarding, so learning to pick myself up from falling, to be persistent, all these things that we practice and Chill, and noticing that all these soft skills that we develop through skateboarding are inherent to like our own personal success, and how can we empower youth to develop those skills to lead to a successful future on and off their skateboards.
9-year-old Tony is already picking up on those important values.
It helped me a lot to become more brave, because at first I kept on falling and off the skateboard and I was kind of scared. But one of the teachers told me that falling is part of learning, so I feel good now. I know how to skateboard properly.
For Chicago Tonight, I'm Evan Garcia.
Skateboarding's not bad, Evan. The program kicked off in November with a donation of 25 custom skateboards by Rockford native Virgil Abloh. He's Louis Vuitton's artistic director, the founder of the Off-White fashion label, and an alumnus of the Boys and Girls Club. The Chill Foundation says it plans to bring skateboard lessons back to East Garfield Park this summer.